symptoms is typically based on bloating and stomach pain and constipation. It can come basically out of nowhere. I'm not really sure which, if it's food or if it's gut bacteria that causes it, but I can wake up in the morning and my stomach is fine. 10 minutes after, it can be bloated and I look like I'm 4 months pregnant. My name is Maria and I'm 27 years old and from Denmark, living in Copenhagen. I'm struggling with IBS. I've been struggling with it for 10 years and I feel it only gotten worse year by year. I'm not really sure what the trigger is always. Sometimes I can predict it, sometimes I can't. Suddenly my stomach like works extremely well and then 2 weeks it doesn't work and then it starts again.
Maria is one of many. It's estimated that 16% of the Danish population suffer from irritable bowel syndrome, IBS. Globally, it's seen in over a billion. And these figures only count for the third of people that know they have it. Most people experience the exhausting symptoms, bloating, abdominal pain, gas, constipation, diarrhea, without realizing it's IBS. To explore how prevalent it really is, Danish researchers decided to look into how it affects Danes aged 18 to 50. Over a three-year period. They found IBS affected 15.4% of this group, and most who had IBS after 1 year also reported symptoms 3 years later. IBS is persistent. Currently, there is no concrete cause or cure. The medical community doesn't really know what to do.
My doctor just looked at me and was like, I don't know what to do. You have this, but I don't know about it.
IBS baffles most doctors, who turn their patients away, suggesting they just need to do trial and error and see how their body reacts. However, the scientific community wants to find answers. They're gathering more and more evidence, finding what truly separates those with IBS, their gut microbes. Researchers note that microbial dysbiosis appears to be a hallmark of IBS. Dysbiosis is defined as an imbalance of gut bacterial communities, and it seems the microbiota is a predominant factor. Dysbiosis in the microbiota can lead to troubles with the immune system and inflammation. How severe someone's symptoms are is also linked with different microbial factors. Researchers have noted patterns in dysbiosis for IBS patients who display either higher or lower levels of certain microbes compared to healthy controls. Digestive issues are a huge societal problem. Scientists want to solve this. And they're finding that the microbiome may be the missing link to help people, like Maria, have a happy gut.